What's up, guys? Today, I am in Geneseo, New York, which is about 30 minutes south of Rochester, so not too far, pretty simple drive. But today, I am doing an outdoor tent wedding on private property. It should be a good one today. It's a younger client, so I think they're going to have a younger guest list. We'll have a lot of fun party tracks. We'll probably be taking it back to the clubs and just having a good time tonight. It's reception and ceremony, but we do have to keep an eye on the sky because they are calling for a little bit of rain. It's actually drizzling out right now and it's pretty cloudy, so I don't know. We'll have to see. Ceremony is about 4:30. Right now it's about noon. And luckily my ceremony setup only takes about 5 minutes to get everything ready and going. So if we do decide to have ceremony, it's about 100 yards away from the tent underneath this little tree that they have. I can set it up pretty quickly. Otherwise, if it does start pouring and raining, then we'll have to pivot and shift and just do everything under the tent. Pretty easy, pretty simple. Nothing too complicated. But today will be good. Man, the last time I've done a tent wedding on private property was during COVID. Now, during COVID, you guys that are watching this probably know that there were a lot of restrictions, there were a lot of lockdowns, and there were a lot of people who were getting married during COVID that didn't want to, I don't know if you want to say conform, if you want to say obey, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. But there are a lot of people that didn't want to have their weddings ruined because they were only allowed a certain amount of people at a venue, or they couldn't have their wedding at a venue or whatever. So if you owned a tent company during COVID, you probably made a ridiculous amount of money because a lot of people ended up renting tents and they just threw their own backyard wedding and they were like, nope, not going to listen. I'm going to do things my own way. I'm going to invite as many people as I want. And that's what it was. So I don't know, you guys, you DJs that are watching this, you know, was it similar for you? Let me know. Comment below what it was like during COVID if you did a lot of backyard tent weddings. But yeah, it's been a while. Tent weddings are good because they're kind of casual, but you can do a lot to make them pretty upscale and elegant and classy and so on. So, but I'm looking forward to this. It's going to be a good one today. And but Tahoe is loaded up. I'm going to get everything inside. You guys know how my gig logs go. We'll just fast forward through everything. And then I probably won't go through all the gear. I'll probably just impose all the different equipment names and types of gear and stuff like that on the video. And then we'll just see how things go for the day. And then I'll get a bunch of B-roll and a lot of pictures. And I'll film people dancing. And you guys know how my gig logs go. So this will be a good one. And just hang out, watch, and we'll see how it goes.
20 minutes later. We'll be right back.
So guys, real quick, just to explain how I got booked for this wedding today. Originally, I was supposed to do a wedding at a country club not too far from me, and unfortunately something happened with the bride and the groom where the wedding was called off. So the bride of that wedding was trying to find another bride that would take over her contract so she wasn't out of a whole bunch of money. And lo and behold, the bride at this wedding reached out to her and was like, hey, I need a DJ. And this bride had actually sent me an inquiry as well off my website. So she originally really wanted to book me, but I was booked for the other wedding. But it worked out because the other bride ended up transferring the contract to this bride. And everything it's just sort of magically worked out for everybody, really. So, yeah, kind of a crazy story, but, you know, those things happen, unfortunately, where weddings get called off, and, you know, you hope you can get booked again for the same date. You guys, if any of you have been in the same situation, comment, let me know. Have you ever had a bride or a wedding that was canceled, and then the contract was transferred to a different bride, and you still ended up working the day? I want to know about it. Comment, tell me the story. I'm always interested in hearing this type of stuff. So the rain didn't stop. It's not pouring, but it's not a drizzle either. So got the umbrella and we just got done wiping down the chairs. Yes, I helped the groomsmen
dry off the chairs. Sometimes you just got to do what you got to do to make your clients happy, right, guys? But yeah, I don't know what's going to happen. Everyone's just kind of like huddled underneath the tent. And I don't know if we'll get a window where it'll clear, but hopefully it does clear up so that we can have a ceremony. Otherwise, I'm going to have to just at least grab the mic and go up. I got all their ceremony music queued up at the reception sound. And we might have to just have the ceremony up there. So, I don't know. We'll see. Rainy days. Gotta love them.
We will do this short and quick and give everybody out of the rain, but they say the best thing on a wedding day is rain. So you guys have all the luck in the world. First, I'd like to begin by welcoming and thanking each and every one of you for being here for Rick and Taylor's day.
What have you?